Hi, I'm Lawrence,
Thomas,
Dennis,
Paul, and today I'll be teaching you how to tape your stick.
Tape.
Tape.
So, Lawrence, what is the use of tape on your stick?
The use of tape of your stick.
Why would we do it? Because my stick's pretty
well,
nice.
If you see that your stick can be maybe a bit slippery, so if you want to stop the ball really good or correctly, you can use some tape so you got more grip on it.
Okay, sounds good.
But for some people it may be annoying because you don't have the feeling anymore. Well, I think that's hoo-ha.
Bullshit.
Oh yeah, let's just say that. So I think you should always, especially if you're the receiver on a penalty corner, you should always have some grip on your stick. So put some tape on it, and we're gonna teach you two ways to do that. Let's start with way number one.
Or
option number one. Option number one is actually the most common version of taping your stick, which is actually going around it very easily. Start off. Start always on the ball side.
The back stick.
So that you.
That's the back stick.
Yeah. So that you can start right over it, and you see that when you start there, you already have the most lower point of your stick. If you have started here, it may be you've got a flip over here and that make it loose. So now it's really tight on your back stick. And you flip it over. And then now it comes to a point, important point. How many distance do you get towards your tape? So just make it half wave at it. And then you got a long point of where you want to tape your stick actually. And then just go upwards actually, and go up, and go up. It doesn't matter how far you want to go. If you like it very high, then just do it like that. I'm actually prefer not that high, so I always stop at the back stick again, so you don't have a nice pointy actually thing. So yeah, that's actually method one. Very easy, right?
It's quite good. Nice.
Are there still any questions?
Nope.
No?
Nope.
No questions?
All pretty clear.
Round the stick, back stick to back stick. Pretty clear.
Now we have a second method or option. And this is actually for the more cheaper way because, well, these things are not could be very expensive for you guys. So if you want to do it a little bit cheaper, you can save some tape for during the other way. But also, it carries, of course, some weight because this makes it a lot of heavier, of course, because you're using a lot of tape. Now, does it not feel a lot, of course, but still, for some people, it could be a lot, make a lot of difference with the weight. So now we're making a lighter version of how to take your stick, which is and it makes it actually cheaper as well. So. We're going to make
this tape is very expensive.
I don't know.
Yeah.
For some people,
40 euros. Yeah.
For some people, it could be very expensive. So, we're going to make
two
long strokes. So you have to measure it by yourself. How long do you want it to get? Do you want to make it? So this is one piece, and you actually want to make two of the same strokes. Oh, sorry.
Do a trick here.
Let's rewind that. Let's rewrite. So we're making a second point actually. Second stroke with the same length. Now you've got two of the same each. There are people who only do just one stroke, but my experience is that you still got some smooth cover points, so that makes it sometimes a bit harder to stop the ball at that point. So we are going to do two sides so that everything is covered and still it's not that much tape that you use. So we've got 2 points, now it's still covered, but what do you see is that these are now 2 points that could easily get off. So what are we going to do next is I want it a bit longer, so we're going to make another stroke and we're going to split these two in half. very easily. And we've got starting one at the back again at the end of each. Sorry, makes it a bit easier. So now you got one here again, and you got one at the bottom again. So that's this method number two. And what's the difference? That this version is actually maybe a bit lighter than the other version. You're not using that much tape, and still you're covering the whole side of your stick, and even the back side is not covered because, well, you're not using the back side. So why waste it then, right?
Absolutely.
Are there still some questions?
So I tape my stick once, and you see I have quite a nice gray stick. But when I get rid of the tape after a few years, all the
glue
is gone.
Yeah.
So what's the best time to get a new tape on your stick?
Well, if you already seen some holes actually in your tape, even at the first time maybe, you know that it's time to refresh your tape. So do it often, because otherwise you get the problem what Thomas is saying, that your glue or your shininess is off the stick. So do it often. I say if you train like two or three times a week with a match, do it once a month. And if you just train once or twice a week, just do once or 2 months. Because you don't use that much stick. But if you already see a hole in it, refresh it as as soon as possible.
Can I use any kind of tape?
Yes, you can. But it needs to be hockey tape. So you're not allowed to use duct tape, bandage tape or medical tape. So use hockey tape, which is very good because it's stronger and the glue stays much more, and you have more grip with it. And you can find them in your hockey stores, or you can buy them online.
You've got a question for a goalie stick?
No.
Do I?
Maybe.
You have a question for a goalie stick?
Yeah, but I can answer it myself.
Okay.
How about the goalie stick, Dennis?
Yeah, good question. Nice, Paul. This is for stopping the balls and having control. But goalies, if you stop the ball, you want the ball to go as far as you want. So you don't really need this. You need the rebound of your stick. So if you can saw in the videos, I had a little bit of tape on it, but this because this is my stick where I coach with. So that's why I had that bit of tape on it. But on my normal stick where I play matches with, I didn't have any tape on it, because then you have more rebounds to clear the ball.
Because goalies don't need to stop the ball, they need to bounce the ball.
Yeah. So for the goalies, it doesn't count.
So don't use it, goalies.
So I'm gonna take this off.
Oh yeah, if you can. It's your stick, so sorry. All right, so did you enjoy this? Have you learned something new?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm not gonna use it.
Did you learn something new? Well, and if you enjoyed this, then like this video and follow us on
Instagram,
YouTube, Facebook.
And thank you for watching.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yes.